Tonight, there is anger here in New York City over five police officers firing 50 rounds into a car last weekend, killing one man, wounding two others. The victims were black and unarmed.
It has happened again. Just 9 days after the uproar in Ferguson, a grand jury in New York City has refused to indict yet another white police officer said to have killed an unarmed black man.
And breaking news tonight in the tragic shooting of an unarmed teen in Florida. Now, Trayvon Martin, armed only with a bag of Skittles and an iced tea, died on the scene after being shot by Zimmerman, but police did not charge Zimmerman.
When I was younger, I used to love going outside to hang out with my friends.
That all changed after it was revealed that Trayvon Martin was murdered by George Zimmerman. And it didn't really help that I constantly heard about black people either committing a crime or being murdered by a police officer in the media. And that made me afraid. I was afraid that I might be the next one to be killed because America seems to be afraid of black people, especially black men. And that fear I had, it caused me to stop doing those things I loved to do before, like going outside to hang out with friends, or even playing basketball in the backyard with my older brother like I used to when I was a kid. And that fear, it also caused me to slowly separate myself from my friends. There was this one time, after a long day at school, I decided to take the bus home instead of walking, and the bus I got on was really packed, so there was only one or two seats left. And one of these seats happened to be next to this young white woman, so I decided to sit down. And halfway through the bus ride, I looked over to my left and I noticed that this woman is not only glaring at me, but she's also clutching her purse. And that made me feel like I did something wrong. The reason these stereotypes exist to begin with is because the media chooses what they want you to see. And often enough, what they want you to see is the negative things that a group of people did. And mainly, those people are black.
Look, just because a person's a specific skin color or race doesn't give you the right to just take away whatever rights or privileges they have. Just because I'm a teenage boy in a hoodie doesn't mean I'm a thug or a gangster. Before you try to judge me or make assumptions about me, maybe you should just get to know me first. Because my skin does not determine my identity. Being black does not mean we're prone to do bad things. Maybe we're just coming home after a long day at work or school and we just want to relax on the bus. Or we're hungry so we go to the corner store to buy junk food or whatever. Just because a person is not the same race as you or the same skin color as you does not mean that they want to harm you in any way.
But if the news chose to show you the good things that black people did, maybe people wouldn't be so afraid of us. So, in 2014, me and my friend decided to go to the Million Man March on Union Square. So when we got there, I was honestly surprised by the amount of people that were there, because I didn't think that these multiple events would impact such a large group of people to the point where they would all come together to protest this one thing that they did not like. And being there, I could feel how strongly these people felt about it, and it taught me something. It taught me that I shouldn't just lie around or sulk about my problems. If it's a problem for me, I should go out there and do something to prevent it from happening to another person instead of just lying around.
Shut it down!
I now know that it's up to me and my friends to create a world where we don't have to worry about our children being shot because of their skin color, or being mistreated because they're black. Look, it's up to every last one of us to create a world where we don't have to worry about our children's safety.